Alrighty guys, Tuesday, September 20th here. Rained this past weekend and dried up enough now we can get this yield plot out. Just got done harvesting the Pioneer number, got two loads on the truck and one on the wagon here. We're putting on the wagon. Measured off earlier, got 1,360 feet of row. Six rows, comes out to 1.404 acres, I think, is what we figured out. It's definitely dried down a lot since last Thursday there, when you saw my video, or when we harvested. I think I got it up till Friday night, but make sure that's good and cleaned out. We'll go to the cow variety next. I have two supervisors, or one supervisor and the guy there. I stand next to Dad's the seed guy. He's Pioneer seed guy. Yeah, get the one out of there. Always looks so good back there and beginning of July, and I come down through here and mow a 30-inch path off in there just so we can see stuff better, but yeah. And go out and check it easier, and it's always kind of painful to do.
I'm sure.
Plant helps definitely a lot. Not as good. Well, they're just dried down quicker probably on the cow, but
the standing a little better than the other.
It is, yeah, and it seemed that from that Pioneer, the ears are so high off the ground, about hits you in the head when you walk through, and I think it just gets, it's just too top heavy is the problem, and I think it, that doesn't help any.
Yeah, but just tell me about the hail damage you guys had.
Yeah. Yeah, crazy part was it stopped about right up here at the quarter line, so it didn't get into the, this yield plot at all.
Yeah,
I'm thankful for that.
Said he got pretty good reimbursement, but then
yeah.
It depends on how it ends up being.
Exactly, yeah. Yeah, that doesn't.
Said they were going to save based on 8,000 plants per acre, and I thought, I didn't ask him, but it's like, they wait then and see what the yield is?
Let's see, how does that work?
Or do they go ahead and do a calculation at that point?
I think they did a calculation off that point on past yield history, I think.
Okay.
Is what I think
that
is.
That would make sense, using your ABC or whatever it's called.
Yeah. Now. Not 100% on that, but I'm pretty sure that's how it is. But it seems like, let's see, how was that? I think he even already got a check for it, maybe.
Yeah, well,
which wouldn't be all bad, because it happened back there in June, and so, you know, and corn was $4 or something, you know, that'd be better than today.
Yeah.
But
yeah, for sure.
Yeah. Do you store corn this fall, or do you sell it, or hope to
have it? Well, I don't have it to do anything now, but if at this point, I would probably tell people, I haven't really looked at where we are as friends to see whether or not it pays, but more than likely this kind of year you just swell off and put it in storage or DP. Storage if you can do it on the farm, probably DP at the elevator. You're going to pick up enough just on basis gain.
Yeah.
That you're going to probably cover all of your costs of any storage or DP and at least something more.
Yeah.
And of course there's always those wild cards out there with the South American crop that widows.
Yeah, it's true.
I don't expect this to be a year where suddenly going to find a whole lot more corn than what they've already predicted.
No, I think they probably over-predicted.
I think. I lean that way.
Yeah. from what I've
seen. That makes it a fairly easy decision to wait.
Yeah. Yeah, it is. I know that a few guys still got corn in the bin from last year, but...
Yeah. It's the kind of year where, you know, what I tell people is, all right, keep track of your costs every month or somehow on a spreadsheet. Know what your costs are. How much extra are you getting at any given point? And any time you can get an extra 10 or 15 cents above what your net was at harvest time, you should be selling some.
That's true.
They will scale up and be preached.
Spread the risk on it a little bit.
I think you're going to get 450 corn. You have to have a disaster next spring or summer for that.
You're going to have another 2012.
Yeah.
But. Yeah, if you could just pick how much you want to make on each bushel, you know, and if you could, you could get. I think guys sometimes go for try and hit the gold mine too much,
yeah,
and that, and then you get, and then all of a sudden it goes down before you picked up the phone and sold it. But
yeah, well, I had 33 people took my short class last winter.
Oh, uh huh.
I've seen a couple of them. Summer, basically somewhere, sometime. And several of them said right away, I should have did what you told me. I should have been selling them. I said, did you sell any? Both of them. None.
Yeah, that's the way it goes. We had it last, I guess this is our third year with that truck, so. Yeah, we have had it 3 years now. It's a little nicer to drive. It's a diesel with an automatic in it, and so.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Pulls the wagon a little better. Back half actually looks a little greener than the front half here.
That is.
And the only thing we can figure out on that is they there wasn't as much or dead end planted as high a population as this, and they did with all the disease and everything and the heat this year. Each plant just did better on its own, but it's hard to say. Yep, and I have to leave a harvest.
Yeah.
What you got to do, you got to harvest. You harvest your, obviously the width of your corn head, and then you got to, and you can pick anywhere you want to start, but then you have to skip over three times the width of your corn head. So we're skipping 18, we got a six row head. We'd have to skip 24 if we had an eight row head. If you had a little longer than what we got, I think if you had a 12 row head, you could about do it in one pass. Yeah, I know you could with a 16 row head, but. Thank you. stinky little ear there. Yeah, once he got into that steel shop out there, he kind of slowed that down. So
okay.
He enjoys the welding and stuff a lot more.
Oh, he still does that?
Yeah, we do that. I didn't do a whole lot this past year. Last summer we had a real big job on campus. But then this next year, the guy that was managing that job last year said he's hoping to have another job about that size this next summer. So we'll see. I don't know.
Yeah.
Which is all right. We had some more repairs due this past summer, and we did some hay baling, a fair amount of it this past summer. Yeah, had wheat and everything else, so we kept busy enough. But
ready to mow your hay baling everywhere?
Here, there, and everywhere. We got 5 acres of alfalfa out here, which is for my cattle.
Okay.
And then there's that goat farm north of Urbana. Don Bergfield likes to go out to that some. I don't know if you've heard him talk about that, but we sell a lot of grass hay to them, and we bale all that up by Grandpa's, and got another place over east of Urbana where we're baling that up.
Okay.
And then they had 5 acres they wanted us to bale up for them, so there was about 2 weeks there in June. We stayed pretty busy with that.
All
then,
small bales?
Yeah, all small squares. We're possibly looking into getting a round baler, but the problem is in Illinois, or at least right around here, if you have extra round bales, getting rid of them is kind of hard to do.
I bet.
And, you know, not just give them away.
Yeah.
But if I got small squares, you know, you can either take it down to Arthur and sell it at the sale barn down there.
Yeah.
Or they'll buy about anything I got left over, so makes it easy. If you ever want a chance to come out and throw some bales, you can always come on out.
Okay. In fact, I remember my Uncle Don, his brother right down the road, I bailed to him some, but he always had a little international PTO driven.
Uh-huh.
Dad had a new Holland with a deep diesel engine on the thing.
Really? But the engine is mounted on it.
30% more than Uncle Don's bail did. Because of that, I had to the way they set them up, but I never learned even how to do that.
Your dad wanted to make sure you worked for when you moved your... I bet any time you'd go bail for your uncle over your dad, you'd go do that.
Yeah.
I don't like to pack them too tight. I pack them about 50-pound bales or so. Yeah. It just makes too much.
Yeah. That's probably all dads were, but they sure seem to put them.
Yeah.
I graduated from grade school, which was 8th grade, in junior high. I weighed 104 pounds, so, and I was wiry.
Yeah.
I was only 135 when I graduated from high school.
Okay, yep. And you can probably eat a big meal along the way every day too, yeah. Yeah, baling in these parts of the country is about gone by the wayside.
Yeah.
So, I got a buddy over by Philo, and he still puts up about 20 acres of hay, and
yeah.
and he hires some of the high. Yeah, right. Yeah, oh yeah. You know Ben. Yeah. He always hires a couple of high school kids to come out and bale for him in the summertime. So, which is probably good for him.
Yeah.
Alrighty guys, got the test plot finished up here. So you got the corn head off, taking it up to Grandpa's now. We'll switch over to beans. Maybe do some beans Thursday. Got 77 acres that might be ready. Not quite sure. We might, we'll see. Maybe do them Thursday, and if there's not any other beans ready, we'll keep the 2188 down here and do corn, and we'll just do the beans with this machine. But we'll see. I think by Friday or Saturday we'd have some corn that's down to 18% or so, and be ready to take it out. And then next week switch over to beans, but we'll see how they come along this week. Should thought twice about moving equipment around 5 o'clock. But anyway, they're probably wondering, the Pioneer made a 261 and tested 21%, and DeKalb made 275 and tested 19%. So we were going to finish out, keep running today, but then we finished opening up the field and it was 21%, so we decided to stop and wait till about 18% corn. A lot of people wondered on my last video why we were harvesting the corn so wet. Well, it's just because that one, that test plot, we just take it out a little wet and get it out of the way. We'll wait till about it. Come on, people. We'll wait till about 18% corn to finish up, or to start running hard in. Nice having to pull over, but sometimes I wish they'd just come on through. Oh well. Part of being spread out. But anyway, I think that'll do it for the NCGA video, so thanks for watching.